ladies and gentlemen of the United Nations. Please welcome our next speaker, Kenny Foster.
Hey guys, I was actually just looking for the bathroom. I mean, I'm a singer-songwriter and from Nashville, and I mean, I do have an Instagram show. It's kind of a big deal, but I had no idea it was this big. But since I've got y'all here anyway, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Quarantine with Kenny. I am your host from coast to coast to coast to coast, but you know all about that, Azerbaijan, am I right? Call me! Anyway, it's me, and I'm so glad to have you guys back here in Nashville. It's been a fantastic week. I don't know what you guys have been up to, but I know I personally have been up to the same stuff I've been doing for the past few months. And it's getting lonely, folks. It's getting lonely. I'm so excited that you guys are here. I have a fantastic guest today, and I'm super excited for you to get to know her better. I'm excited to talk to her, and I don't think we should waste any more time, and we should just bring her on in. Ladies and gentlemen, so in 2019, she put out an EP called Redneck Hollywood, okay? I don't know if you checked it out, but get on all of your streaming services. Go buy the thing. Do you remember buying music? You can do that too still. I just want to let you know that. So she signed to Broken Bow Records. She spent years crafting her songwriting and her sound that she calls bell-bottom country, and I can't wait to talk to her a little bit more about that. She moved from her family farm in rural Louisiana. Music was a family affair back there on the farm. I want to talk to her a little bit about that. And through a lot of different ways that we come to the songwriting and music thing, she also was a Hannah Montana impersonator. I have so many questions, I can't even get to it. She released Rolling Stone on April 24th, and she has a new single coming out for us on the 31st of this month. That's no time at all. I can't believe July is almost over. It's killing me. But she has been over in Europe to your guys' neck of the woods. She played on C2C London. She was on Eric Paisley's Mr. Nice Guy tour, which had to have been a lot of fun. She shared a stage with Morgan Wallen, Rodney Atkins, Randy Houser, Ashley McBride, Justin Moore, Josh Turner, just to name a few. Not yet Kenny Foster. We'll get to that point. I'm not worried about it. But when she toured Germany in 2019 with Eric Paisley, it must have been freaking amazing. But without further ado, please let's just bring her into this world that we all inhabit. So put your hands together. You're typing together for Miss Lainey Wilson. Lainey, there she is. Oh my gosh, look at you! I love that hat.
I'm trying to cover up this hair day,
dude. Why do you think I have the bean on? Let's talk about it. Let's talk about
it. I love it, man. How are you?
Oh, I'm breathing, moving around. It's another day. It's going to be hot as all get out outside because that's what Nashville does to us.
You're right about that. Good.
Tell me about your sign. What's it say? I know it's backwards right now.
Hey, y'all.
Oh, man. Check it out. Check it out.
Oh, my gosh.
Come on now. We're keeping it rural up here. How are you? Like, what have you been doing? What has this looked like for you this entire time?
Man, you know, I've been trying to keep myself busy. It's been different every single day.
Sure.
I have written probably 35 songs, you know, during this time, which, I mean, through Zoom, I guess it's not that bad, you know?
It's not for you? Because, man, I have a hard time with it, I'll be honest.
Oh, in the beginning it was rough, and I feel like sure. The people who I mean, my buddies that I write with, like, you know, every 2 weeks, it's not, you know, I mean, it's a
sure.
pretty, you know. But I feel like the blind writes, you know, the people that you've never met before, and you just, you know, you're just in there.
Yes.
Like, what you want to write about today? It's a little awkward.
But, it's completely weird.
You know, figuring it out. Just
good.
I'm very thankful that I still have songwriting because
yes,
I know you understand it is therapy, and
yes,
I need my therapy.
So, have you found this? Have you found it cathartic? Like, have you been writing about this moment, or has just the expression of thoughts and ideas generally been the thing that you've enjoyed?
I feel like definitely my songs during this time are a little different than, you know, when they were, than when we were actually in the room writing on Music Row. Sure. But, I feel like I'm experiencing a lot of things that everybody probably watching this is, you know, a lot of ups and downs and highs and lows, and I'm okay one minute, I don't know what I'm doing the next. And so I think it's going to be interesting to see, you know, what kind of songs come out of this quarantine.
Sure. Well, and how and when we'll ever get to share them with the world, right?
Oh, I know.
Because I don't know about you, I love doing this sort of thing, but it's not playing live, is it?
Oh my gosh, I miss the face to face thing. I sure do. And, you know, I feed off the crowd. I feed off my co-writers. I'm sure a lot like you. You know, like I love people. I love being around them. But we're doing the best we can right now.
I know we are. So, have you made it back to Louisiana during this time? You've been back with the family for a little bit?
I have. Yes, I did a couple times. I went down for my nephew's birthday party. He just turned one.
Nice.
And that has been a really good thing, too. It's been a blessing, really, because I was there when he took his first few steps. I got to see him walk and stuff like that. I'm just trying to, you know, I'll go down there for a couple weeks, and I'm like, all right, time to come back to Nashville for something crazy.
Well, because I imagine even being home, it's a little different than it is normally, because you're not going to the same places, you're not getting to do the same things.
Oh, yeah.
It's got to be crazy. How is Louisiana managing through all of this? They're doing a good job, babe.
They're definitely trying. Louisiana has had it pretty bad, you know, because New Orleans, Mardi Gras, around that time, it was pretty rough. But, yes, my family, I'm from a town of about 300 people. So,
what's it called?
It's called Baskin.
Baskin?
Now, I'm not talking about Carol Baskin.
Not talking about Carol. Killed her husband, whacked her.
It's so funny. Anytime I say Baskin now, everybody's like, Carol?
We can't escape it.
No. Yeah, so if you've ever heard of Monroe, Louisiana, like, you know, the Duck Dynasty area.
Of course, come on.
I'm about 30 miles south of there, so.
Okay, that's great.
It's
so tell me a little bit. So you've been over to Europe. You were over there. Tell me a little bit more about Pasley's Nice Guy Tour. How was that? Did you enjoy yourself? Was that your first time over?
It was. Well, it was my first time to Germany. And, golly. You know, Eric's one of my good buddies. I mean this when I say it every single time. It's very rare that you find, you know, an artist who is just as kind as they are talented. And Eric Pasley is truly that person. You know, my dog is biting my leg, so I'm going to put her in my lap.
Sounds good. What's your dog
doing? Bad. This is Hippie.
Oh, what's up, Hippie?
But it was so much fun. Like I said, the first time I went over there, and the last, everybody just made me feel right at home. I mean, they were singing the words to my music. I'm like, y'all don't know me from Adam. You saw me on a flyer, and you took the time and went and listened to my stuff, and it's a crazy feeling.
It's a nice breath of fresh air, especially when you're slugging it out at county fairs and competing with all the bar crowd, man. I know.
Don't nobody care at all.
Yeah, they're sweet as hell over there, man.
It was really great. I mean, I can't wait to go back. I mean, I'm itching.
I know. And were you supposed to be back this year? Because I know I was.
We were definitely talking about it. We were trying to, you know, figure it out.
Breaking my heart. Anyway, so all of these fine, wonderful people, they actually wrote in some fan questions before all of this happened. So let me hit you with them, okay? Are you ready? All right. Well, we've already covered some of it because they were asking about how you felt about the German fans. But what did you think of the German countryside when you were down?
Beautiful. You know, we rented a car and we drove everywhere. I got to drive on the Autobahn. And
that's so fun.
Oh my gosh. I had way too much fun. I was like,
white knuckle.
I was born for that.
You had
honestly,
no idea.
I drive around here like I'm on the Autobahn sometimes. So.
Nashville has got a little picture of you on the rear view.
Oh, yes. Good Lord. But it was beautiful. Honestly, like, it reminded me of, you know, of some parts of the States, you know, just how beautiful and open. And I saw a lot of farming and stuff, and that just speaks right to my heart. So We went all over Germany. We were in Berlin, Munich, Aschaffenburg. I mean, everywhere.
That's awesome.
It's great. And the people.
Yeah, it's so good. So tell us more. Here's another question. Tell us more about your bell-bottom country sound. First of all, tell us where the, how the sound got developed, and then tell us about the name, or maybe you do that first.
Okay, so the best way for me to describe bell-bottom country is country with a flair.
Right.
So, you see what I did there?
Yeah, I did, because I know fashion.
I love it. No, I mean, I love throwback things. I love, you know, throwback music, but also just like, you know, style, the clothing and everything. And when I was little, I used to be obsessed with this one pair of bell bottoms. My mom was like, all right, Lainey, you got to take them suckers off. We got to wash them. You know, it's time to throw those things in the wash. So I've always just been obsessed with that kind of stuff. And, you know, I love the whole Stevie Nicks, Janis Joplin kind of look. And, and I love the whole, like, musically, I love the whole, you know, fresh, but also, like, familiar kind of sound. So I think that's kind of the best way for me to explain
it. Did you find that type of music throwback? Was it the authenticity or was it the warmth of the sound? What was it that you enjoyed about the throwbacks?
The authenticity, for sure. Yeah, for sure. And Jay Joyce really helped me find that, you know. I feel like, you know, sometimes we try a lot of different things before we find the thing that is like the most, you know, that speaks right to you and is really the most you.
Heck yeah.
And he just helped me, you know, tie a little bow on top, and he's really good at that. You know, he wanted to get to know me and get to know, you know, what I love, what I don't like, but also just about my life in general. And I feel like he kind of brought that, like, he just made it sound that way. I don't know how in the world you do that, but somehow he does.
A Sherpa, if you will, leading you up the mountain. All right.
It's nuts.
Yeah, it is. So I see Kerrigan here in the comments is from Baskin. I don't know if you know Kerrigan, but she's
yes.
From
hey, Kerrigan, how you doing, girl?
So good. All right. Here's we got two more questions for you, and then we'll bust in the rest of this. So you have a song called Sunday Best. They want to know what your favorite pastime is on Sundays.
Man, well, I will tell you, I think it has changed, you know,
Normally, as you've grown up or as you've moved, or what do you think?
So while I was traveling a whole lot on the road playing shows, Sundays were really my days of trying to get back to Nashville, whether that meant flying back to Nashville or, you know, in the van with those stinky boys or whatever,
stinky
just
boys.
Trying to get back here. And
don't know anything about that.
Oh my gosh. Those boys. but now I feel like my Sundays, I have just tried to like get outside, go on a hike, do something, stay active, be out in the sunshine, because at the end of the day, that's what, you know, that's what makes me happy.
Where do you hike when you're in town?
I go to Percy Warner. Yep. There's this really cool trail out there. I love to go. Anything. I got me one of those little, I think you call them an Inu. Little the hammock things, you know what I'm talking about?
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Okay. Sure. So I've been trying to do that kind of stuff, you know, just be still, because to be honest with you, I'm real good at that.
Yeah, real bad at it. Why do you think we stay on the go all the time otherwise? Yeah, that's been a stretching thing. As bored as I've gotten, I've also gotten, like, stressed in the same way. It's sort of like,
I know.
Because I feel like maybe you're this way, that I grow through experiences.
Same.
So like when I have an experience, I then get to reflect on either how that was different or how it made me feel. And then out of that comes, you know, inspiration for writing or.
Same. And I'm having to learn where to, you know, how to find inspiration other places. And I've been reading, which is not like me. I'm so ADD. I'm like squirrel, you know.
That's fine. My wife is a huge reader. I think she's at 42 books since the beginning of the year. Listen, we literally just this week we put up a. Have you heard those little free libraries?
Yes.
Do you know these things are? We put one up in our front yard this morning or this week, and the whole neighborhood, all the kids have been running in and changing books.
I love that. She's like,
it just melts her little heart because she loves reading. She loves it.
I love that. I wish I did. I'm learning to love it, but
yeah. I know, but somebody who wants to experience things, I get it. You and me, simpatico. We don't even have to get it. So one more. One more, and I'm interested in this. This was not me asking, but this is also me asking. I'm sure you get this all the time. Hannah Montana impersonator. Was this one of those? Where, did you have an agent that like got you these gigs, or did you just tell me? Just tell me more.
Okay. So let's back it up to eighth grade.
Okay.
Little eighth grade Lainey. My teacher at the time, her name was Miss Poland. She had a little girl. She was turning like 10 years old that year. And Miss Poland had asked me to just put on a wig and show up as Hannah Montana. And, well, of course, I took it, you know, a little too far. And I went and bought the I went and bought the karaoke track. I already had the sound system. And the first time I played was at this birthday party on the back of a flatbed trailer.
And come on now, Louisiana. I like that.
It's crazy. It spread like wildfire. It did. And next thing I know, I mean, I was going all over Louisiana, Mississippi, Arkansas. The last one I did was here in Tennessee at St. Jude. And
oh, nice.
It was just, I did it for 5 years.
Wow.
5 years. And Lainey Wilson would open up for Hannah Montana. If
nice. Of course you did. Of course you did. Because that's just smart.
I'm like, well, they
got to
know my name too.
Heck yes, dude, I know, man. Well, I did a lot. I used to do a lot of acting before I got into music songwriting, and but it was one of those things where you realized you were taking on roles of other people, and you're like, I don't know that I could do this long term, because when does Kenny Foster get to say something?
That's right.
And I know there's way more money in acting. Believe me, it was supporting my music habit for many years.
Yeah.
I don't know. It just didn't feel right. For the same reason you were talking about all of your influences, the authenticity of it. It was just like, yeah, I can authentically be somebody else, but I don't know that that's good long term for me personally.
No. I'm telling you, I was excited to hang the wig up, but I will tell you, I made more money then than I ever thought about. I mean, I was killing it.
I know.
Just like killing it. That, exactly.
Keeping it real. Okay, so we every single week on the show, we talk a little bit about charity, and this one's special because you've got a connection with it. So it's actually extra special, if I may say so myself. The charity that we are highlighting this week is Extra Special People. Yes. So it has a legacy of one woman, Martha Wiley. Am I correct?
Yes. Yes.
That's great. So she has a passion for children and young people with special needs. She wanted to create a place where they and their families could focus on their abilities, not their disabilities. So it serves individuals through camps, year-round support, family support, and there's three annual events.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit more, Lainey.
Okay,
you're involved with one of these events. Yeah?
I got asked to come down there and judge the Big Hearts Talent Show that ESP puts on, and I did that February 15th of this year. And the reason I got connected with those guys is because years ago, about probably 5 years ago, I became a fan of this little boy on Facebook. His name is Nick Smith. And he is just the cutest, funniest little character. I mean, he's probably got like 200,000 Facebook followers. He's just... Everybody loves him. His name is Nick Smith. So if you haven't seen him, you need to go check him out. Write it down. But it's so crazy how life works, because about 4 years after I had, you know, just been following his journey and stuff, he ended up becoming a fan of my music, and we somehow got connected and just became friends and, you know, exchanged numbers and everything. We were just buddies. We were FaceTiming, and he asked me to come down there and judge his talent show and be a part of it. And I was just like, this is right up my alley. You know, this is my thing. I just enjoy this so much. And it was so much fun to go down there and see all those kids. Just, I mean, they were just so excited and happy to be a part of something so cool, you know. And I mean, I was a very small part of it, but I just like to stay involved, you know. So we're raising money right now for the kids to actually go to camp and stuff. And because these kids, they eat it up. It is just, and thankfully they're still able to go to camp right now. They're, you know, masking up and doing the whole thing.
Sure.
But it's an opportunity for the kids and their families, for everybody to connect, you know, with families who understand exactly, you know, what they go through or deal with. And it's just great.
That's great. I, I'm I know what camps did for me growing up. I'd spend all summer at one. You know, I'd hop from camp to camp to camp. And those talent shows, man, that's your opportunity. That's your testing ground. They know all about it. That's really awesome. Well, hey, if you guys want more information there, if you want to look to donate or get involved, we have links in the bio here at Sound of Nashville. So please check that out. Lainey, thank you so much for bringing to us. But now it's time, I don't know if I fully prepared you for this, for a little game that we like to call Wheel of Filters. So what we need to do is go to your little happy face sparkles there.
Let's do it.
And I need you to find a filter that fits your mood right now. You can spin through and pick it at random. I don't really care.
What about that?
Okay, you told me about this. Tell me what
basically, the
filter is. How do I do it?
So it's just a bunch of like jumbled words, and you have to figure out what it's trying to say.
Okay, fair. Push it. Make sure it works. Let me see if it works on the
Instagram. You want me to try it?
Yeah, just go ahead and give it a try. Let's see what happens.
Oh, shoot. Hold up. I don't think it's gonna.
See, that's what I was worried about. No!
I know. That makes me sad.
Because it's a really fun game, right? I will get it. Don't even worry about it.
Oh, what about the genetic heritage one? I wonder if that one would work.
Give it a try. I don't know. I just work here.
No!
Bah! Instagram Live, get on it. You have
That's
this great
what I'm talking about.
Well, there we go. You on TV. Miss Hannah, what is this? Oh, that's spooky. It was blue eyes.
Best of both worlds. I'm Hannah Montana all over again. Bam, bam, bam.
Yeah, do you want to be? Do you want, look at me. Well, I mean, I feel like a monster on top of this guy, right? Like, I'm going to get you. Who is that? Is that Justin? Like, there he is. Whoa, he jumped.
This is Tim McGraw. And you know, okay. Tim McGraw is from my area.
No, for real?
He is. Yeah, he's from right down the road.
I had no idea.
You're back at it. Man, there's so many good ones.
I know, that's what I'm saying. Here, let's just find one. I kind of there you go. Yeah. Ham and eggs. Here's one Mia as a silhouette.
Oh my gosh. I'm Luke Combs right now.
Yeah, you want to be I don't know if you can step to the Lindsay L. Luke Combs moment, but we had one. It's funny because you've got two hats on. They're like
doubling up.
They doubling look like up. I. That's really funny, actually. Oh God, that's
terrifying.
Oh no. Did you see The Ring? Did you ever watch the movie The Ring?
Snippets of it. I did not make it all the way through it. I've got to be honest with you.
Because it's freaking scary as hell. It's so scary. Yeah, I was
is
with
pretty my, scary watching you right now. I'm not gonna lie.
Well, you're just going to have to do it.
Oh my gosh. Let's see. I wish this gibberish one would work.
I know. I'm really sorry that it doesn't. Wait, what? So did you have a Hannah Montana? I did Harry Potter 1 week. when you were Hannah Montana, did you have a different voice or were you just you?
I was just me, but I mean, you know, she like her Hannah Montana music was pretty Southern anyway.
Sure.
I did have to get into character, you know. I mean, like when I
what was that process like?
I'm Hannah Montana.
Did you actually watch the show, or did it just happen? Because like,
I did watch the show.
I missed it. I missed it somehow. I don't know.
It was a good show. I actually heard that they're bringing it back.
Are they?
I know. I was like,
but who's gonna be Miley?
I don't know. I have no idea. I'm like, well, dang it. Does that mean I'm gonna have to be Hannah Montana all over again?
We're not. Listen, if you don't want to go there, no one is gonna make you, Lainey. It's not gonna.
If Hannah Montana is opening for me, fine.
You better believe it. You better. She can pretend to be you from now on. That's what I'm trying to say. So hey, let's give the people what they want. Will you sing us a song tonight? Are you down for it? I would love to hear it. Please.
You gonna do something too, huh?
Oh, come on, please. I'll even go first if you want. I don't care.
Hey, you go first.
I'm going first. I'm gonna set the mood. No, I'm not.
Do it.
So this is actually one of the songs. I haven't released this song. I haven't.
Okay.
It's just one that I wrote at the beginning of this quarantine, so it just seems to make sense. Man, you might get it.
I'm sure I will.
Our orange juice came in a tin can. They were shooting with the daisy gun we found in the woods. That was our spot until we got caught. We rolled our backs fast as we could, even though the living was good. They called us the poor kids. They hand me down beat up four kids. They got it from the Goodwill store kids. But we didn't know any different. That's how it was. Poor kids, wearing all last year's clothes, kids. We were never gonna have what they did. But the shame is, never gonna know what we missed. Those poor kids.
Yeah.
Probably never built a blue, probably never had a blue tongue. There's a water park or a cardboard box for tea. Built a tree for a spare board. Had a mattress for a trampoline. Now our folks see. Just be with poor kids. The hand-me-down beat-up poor kids. They got it from the Goodwill store kids. But we didn't know any different. Cause that's how it is with poor kids. Wearing on last year's clothes, kids. We were never gonna ever let them. But the shame is, they're never gonna know what they miss. Those poor kids. Oh, those poor kids. Looking at those days, I would change everything. We knew we had it made. We could still hear them say. Look at those poor kids, turn away and just ignore kids. Never gonna be any more kids, living a life that was so good. But that's how we're poor kids, wearing all last year's clothes, kids. We were never gonna have what they did, but shame is, never gonna know what they missed. Those poor kids. All those poor kids.
Oh my gosh, Kenny. That's incredible.
Thank you so much. Yeah, I'm thinking about putting it on this record. What do you think? I think you should go there?
Yes. Okay. Yes, at the top of your list.
Okay, yes, ma'am. It is.
That was incredible.
Thank you so much.
I think you might be getting some dang good songs during quarantine if you got that.
Well, listen, we're trying. We're trying hugs and kisses, you know.
Gosh. Just like also, everybody. I was noticing when you were playing, I was like, look at the flow, man. You got some flow. Your hair is like, we try to get our hair to do that.
I know, honestly, it's a point of contention between me and my wife. She, let me tell you how I did this morning.
You're going to make me mad.
That's what I did this morning. And then I put this hat on. So this
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
A little jealous.
I'm sorry. I'm not trying to do that. I'm not trying to incite that.
That was rude.
Anyway, sing us something, man. I want to hear you.
Okay.
I can't wait.
All right. So this song comes from experiences that I've had in relationships,
mm-hmm.
both good and bad, but they have taught me how to treat people, but also like how I want to be treated, you know?
Sure.
And, so it's called Things a Man Ought to Know.
I love this song.
You better write it down, Kenny.
Thank you.
Yeah, Lady Winston!
Thank you.
Can I tell you what I love about that song the most is that second verse, you keep the same agenda as the first, but now you're applying it both to things that a man ought to know and the relationships that you're beleaguering. And like, I just freaking love it. It's genius from start to finish. That's a great song.
Thank you. Jonathan Singleton and Jason Nix, man, I'm telling you.
Well, listen, as I said, you can do a lot worse. Hey, Lane, thank you so much for coming today. It's been so fun. Thank you for being so sweet. Thanks for being thank you for singing for this, man. I really appreciate it. So we like to leave here on Quarantine with Kenny. We are here every Thursday, so if you guys are tuning in, come on back. I mean, there won't be Lane Wilson there. I'm sorry, but she just but we're here every Thursday on Sound of Nashville. But we always like to leave. I always ask my guests if they would leave us with a joke.
Okay.
Do you have a joke for us, my
dear? I do have a joke for you. I don't have a lot of jokes.
Hey.
I feel like a lot of my jokes are just kind of like spur of the moment.
Sure.
Some people might laugh, they might not. But this is like the one joke I was like.
Okay. You only need one today.
Okay. So let's see. I'm probably about to mess this up.
I won't look at you.
What's the difference between a guitar and a tuna fish? What? You're probably going to get it.
You can tune a guitar, but you can't tune a fish?
You are lying to me.
I'm sorry. Was that right?
Yes. You're a good songwriter.
Sorry. The music ones, they're all in here somewhere.
That was good. Good job.
Well, thank you so much for bringing it. Ladies and gentlemen, please go follow her, Lainey Wilson Music, at Lainey Wilson Music. Go buy, go stream, go do all the things, and we will see you next time around. Lainey, take care of yourself.
Okay, I appreciate you.
All right, cheers. Bye, everybody. See you guys.